So I'll talk about performance analysis and the coach's assessment of the technique curriculum. So I want to start with a quote from a coach that I've been working with when I suggested that we do some more rigorous evaluation of the technique of our youngest players. I should add that we have cadet and junior players, and the focus of the cadet curriculum is very much on the technique development, and then with the junior players, it's about having mastery of those strokes and in combination, and with a focus more to the match situation. So when I said this to the coach about using high speed quality video, try and do some quantitative analysis as opposed to just qualitative work, he looked at me like I was mad, and you know, he said, "You can't quantify table tennis technique. That's not what we do in table tennis. It's about the coach's experience, blah, 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 and observation. Everything is in here." So I said, "Well, I think we can, and I've done this with other sports that hadn't done it before, so let's give it a go." So I think the key point is here is that as someone who has not played table tennis at a high level, I'm just a hobby player, but somebody who knows about analyzing technique, there has to be a lot of conversation between the coach, him informing me, and then vice versa, that I have to inform the coach about how we can maybe do things, using examples from other sport maybe, or just trying things and gradually having a common ground. So I left this for a couple of days. Okay, we can't do it. And then you try something and you show the coach, and eventually we've got somewhere, and we still have a long way to go, but I'll show you how we've started with this. The point is that just because something's not normally done in table tennis, it doesn't mean it shouldn't be tried. So somebody has to be the first to do something, to develop a test, to develop a process for technique evaluation or something. So we have to move with science if we want to take the sport further. That's my humble opinion, but that's something I'm convinced on. Why should we try and quantify the assessment process as opposed to just the coach saying, "Well, this guy has a nice forehand topspin"? It means we can track progress in a standardized way. We can set targets for players, which is always nice. If you tell a player he's achieving 4 out of 6 and these are the points to get to 5 out of 6, it's players like numbers and they like to see progress as opposed to us just telling them things which can to them can be a throwaway comment. As I said, we can compare between players, which is nice. And also in my case, I work in a large academy where we have lots of different management staff, and management like to see numbers. They don't necessarily understand about what the process is and what table tennis correct technique is. But if we can show them numbers and hopefully improvement, then this is nice for the program. This is myself in my office space, and I sit right next to this guy. So initially it's about having lots of conversation, as I said, between the performance analyst and the coach. So I can explain to him a possible process. We can discuss the techniques of various key shots, and we can, after some time, come to some understanding of what are the key criteria, what is the best camera position, for example, to be able to evaluate that. And also to have some sort of scale to quantify what is happening. We decided on some basic criteria first for some simple analysis, with a view to improving this in the future, or developing this, should I say. Don't worry too much about the actual words, I'll just try and explain. So this is just a very small snapshot, some of our players for some of the key criteria. So our cadet years are years 7, 8, and 9. So within each year we have different strokes that the processes that the boys should have hopefully mastered them by the time they move on to the next year. And they're different between the years, so there are between 7 and 8 key strokes for each year. We identify the key points for each of the techniques to be analyzed, and then we have a scoring system based on the video. So this is high-speed video of 6 shots from different angles, and then we can look at whether the criteria were satisfied for how many shots, and were the balls returned successfully, and if so, were they with precision and accuracy. So we can have a scoring system from 2 to 5, or it's actually ineffectively from 1 to 6, but none of our players are at the level where 6 would be, for example, the cadet boys that are achieving gold medals and are the best players in the world for their age group. So this is just a snapshot. This leads into a more generic classification of the boys, incorporating lots of different tests and for example. So we're in the initial stages of this, but this will be then put on the smarter based system and shared, and we hope to develop this further in the future. So I'll go into more detail on the next slide about what this looks like. So if we have a player and we've done the video and I've sat with the coach and we've done the analysis and we've seen what criteria satisfied, etc. So we may have a player who, with the forehand drive, he's achieved a score of 2.5 at one instant in time. So we're testing the players 3 times a year for this, start, middle and end. So we can use the feedback in training, live feedback through Dartfish. The player afterwards, he will get this video with the coach's evaluation sent to his smartphone so he can review it. So it's also not about taking numbers, it's about improving the technique of the player. So there's some points there which the coach has mentioned. So that we can then work in training with the player on improving these points. So using certain video software packages, we can add information to those. So this was about the footwork, it was about the transfer of weight from the right to the left leg. And with this player, he didn't score so highly. One of the points was his wrist angle position. So we could work in training on those, reinforce the points through video analysis. So one of the targets was to improve his forehand drive by the next testing session. So we wanted this to improve to 3.5, I think we set the target. And he achieved this by working hard in training on some key points. So then we go back to the testing stage. We test him and we reevaluate, and we try any areas of perceived weakness, then we try to improve. So that's the process. So future direction, what I've done with other sports, I've used motion analysis systems such as Vicon quite extensively. I've worked with national goal squads with football for kicking analysis. And this is a lot more rigorous. We get a lot more information. However, we don't want to suddenly go from nothing to full-blown motion analysis for all our players. This is maybe a future direction. And we've done this successfully with other sports. So hopefully in the future we can do this with table tennis. But it's about getting the basics sorted first and developing them to do some more rigorous work in future. And that will also lead to some nice applied research. So we actually have done some pilot testing with using Vicon motion analysis system, and we're working on some projects, some virtual reality projects actually in association with the university. So maybe in the future I can tell you a little more about that. If you are a coach, are you open to new ideas, for example, as this coach was? So if you can't quantify technique, I think you can. Are you open to discussion? Yes. Okay, let's do something. Don't be afraid to have the difficult discussions, as they may be the ones that lead to some good work happening. So it may be that you have some heated discussion with your coach to start with, but if you are adamant that you can help, there's no reason, if you have a good working relationship, you cannot get some good work happening. Because ultimately, if you're a sports science or a coach, you're both there to try and help the athletes, the players develop. So does anyone want to ask any questions or discuss things from this example? Come on, you must have at least one question.
The first thing I would say to debate is, you need to be in a box. Like you're saying, you're a coach. I'm not a coach, I'm a player.
Yeah.
I still pursue to be as good as I can be, given the physical and where I am in the chronological clock. But can I coach? Yeah, I would say the 35 years that I've involved in a degree in sports science. What I would say is, what you're working on is fantastic, but your average coach back in England, the school I've taught in recently works with the Norwich City Football Academy.
Yeah.
And all what you're talking about is the boys that attend the school, this is the processes they go through. But this is so far removed from coaches wouldn't have. The guy that's the coach is somebody who gives 2 nights a week and turns up for 2 hours.
Okay.
And it's phenomenal. There needs to be a stepping stone to encourage people who have played or in each of the countries at a level to want to become the coach, to take this on board. And the benefits are without doubt. But you're right in everything you say. You have to start somewhere.
Well, our coaches are full-time, and it's, you know, initially it was about lots of observation of training and matches and just casual conversations with the coach over dinner. And my perception of the game and how coaching works in table tennis is a lot different to how it was when I first started. And coaching in table tennis is a lot different to other sports I've worked with. You know, I appreciate a lot the work of these guys because they work very hard. It's long hours. There's no shortcut to player development. It's countless hours at the table, many balls with a bad back, and these coaches are very dedicated and work very hard. So I'm very happy to be working with them. But I can give you this example to say that initially there was not so much support for the concept, and now, you know, I will do things with the coach, and he will say, "Oh, that's fantastic! You know, this is really helpful." To have, for the player to have the video live in training from different angles, to be able to take out his smartphone after and review the video with the coaching points on there to reinforce. You know, my coach always says to me, if I was a 16-year-old player with these things, you know, I would have loved this. So I think
that's the,
next generation of coaches will can potentially take these things on board to get, I wouldn't even call this the next level. I think it's the level that a lot of other sports are at. So for me, table tennis has to step forward and embrace these new technologies, new ideas. And that's where perhaps I don't consider myself a table tennis expert, as I say, but coming from other sports, from a different background with new ideas, that's maybe where I can help in the sport of table tennis move forward.
The first point you've got up there as a talking point is something that everybody needs to be open to.
Yeah.
Whatever level you're at, you should be open to new ideas.
Yeah.
And what is measured success? The person that's had a national champion in their home country might sit there on a pedestal and say, everybody should be open to new ideas. Mm. And it's a big problem. Because people who perceive themselves as being successful are not open to new ideas.
Yes.
This
yeah.
is the way I've done it.
If it isn't broke, don't fix it.
Yeah.
That's in there. But, you know, you only have to take examples from other sports where things have been introduced and all of a sudden people have realized they've been left in the dark ages because the sport's gone to a new level. Can you imagine, you know, football, Premier League football teams doing... eating gammon egg and chips before the match and, you know, running with bin bags on these days. It's not, it's all very structured, very professional. But it wasn't so long ago they were doing those things. You have to move with the times. I've lost count of the number of conversations I've had with our coaches where I've said, you know, I've been mischievous and said, look, I don't think that's right. I think we should do this. That's not how table tennis works. So what? Let's try it. And I realize that not everyone's in the situation where they can do that. But for us, we're very lucky in that we can. And this is not to say this is how it should be done. This is just, I'm just giving you examples of how we've decided to do it.